We're gonna look at the AF Ming bow versus AF Tatar bow. Both of the bows strung up. Let's do a little bow on bow action. For this plane to pass, starting from the arrow pass, I'm going to try to stay with the profile side view of both as best I can. Bows unstrung. See that difference of profile? Look at that. See, there's quite a difference in the recurve from the handle. Okay, that was the Ming bow. Missed shot. First shot, that chicken so lucky. It was right above his head. Got him in the neck again. Sweet. That's where he was. That's where the other one hit. He was standing right there. It's like, I gotta look at that video. Maybe it was like actually resting right there. That's funny. I take out the top of his head. No way. That's a perfect fit for an arrow. Is that what I did? I'll have to check. That's funny. I haven't shot the Tatar bow in a while, so I might not do that great.
They're both great bows, and they're comparable. The Ming bow and the Tatar by AF Archery. The Ming bow, it being longer and larger, accommodated my longer draw length and my height and my arm span better than the AF Tatar, where I felt kind of squished. I prefer the Ming bow. I like it. It fit me better. It's more comfortable. I don't feel like I'm fighting it. The Tatar bow, I feel like I'm fighting at my anchor point. Whereas the Ming, I didn't. So, hey, it's a nice bow. It's AF. Can't go wrong. Thank you again to Hunting Door. Go check out huntingdoor.com for their excellent selection, reasonable prices.